thing to talk about is table. Next thing to talk about is table. So when we're talking about table, how do you organize your table in HTML? That is what we want to talk about right now. So table should be under, I want to make sure that we are doing the right thing. Let's put it under header. Be under head under the note or under the main section, which is our article selection on the left. Okay. Let's be under the main section. Okay, so let me create a section for it where we can start our table right away. Okay, session, yes, bring it down. So for table, like formation, we also come in there. Like I told you, I really like organization. So we'll start with the head. We have table head, we have table data, and each of them, the table head, just like the way it stands, that is the head of the table. The table data, just like it stands, is the head of the table as well. Okay? So we want to take one after the other. I'll start with the head. We'll start with the subtotal. So I like formatting my work very well. So I'll start with caption. We're talking about table, so type your table as usual. Table. Bring it down. The first thing, we want to add a caption. Caption is like a title to your table. I can have a title, you know, I like to show you see the title of the flow by table head and table data, which is the table body, okay? So let's start with the caption. So you can type your caption. That's just the way it sounds, caption, okay? Type your caption. Then here, let's say we are going to make a list of students, list of senior students in a classroom. List of senior students. Okay, list of senior students. Want to form a table for list of students, then maybe those in JS1, SS1, SS2, SS3. So that is what I want to do. So I've gotten the caption. Right after your caption, okay, let me control save so I can see your work and see what you are doing as usual. Okay, I won't just be working and we are not seeing what we are doing. Okay. Let's view our work and see what we did is correct. Let's view it because we need to end work with our work. Let's view it on live server. See if we are doing the right thing, okay? And here it is. See it? The list of senior students. List of senior students. Both will be bigger than this. Maybe because of the file last one, and let it be inserted. List of senior students. So that's the caption. That's the head. That's the heading that we're using. Okay? To go to the next one, start the caption, which is the T head. T head stands for table head, okay? Table head, that is the T head. T head, which is the table head, okay? T head, we call it the head, table head, okay? Bring it down now. T head, which stands for table head. So on this table head, you want to bring a list of no students. Let's start with table row here. Table row. Bring it down. And under the table row, so after bringing it down, now go to table datum. Bring it down as table. Let's start with row one, which is TD, put data. TD. Let's say the first one should be, the first student you're talking about should be SS1 student. SS1 student. Copy it. So I can just be like SS1, SS2, SS3. So just three pieces. Copy, bring it down. Change it to SS2 student. And lastly, SS3 student. You can do your one student, your two student, your three student, anyone you want to do. Okay, save your work. Let's see what we're doing and see how far we're going. Your work as usual. You open it on live server so we can know what we're doing. Bring your last server down. Let them be together so we can know what we're doing. So, a list of no students say that we have SS1 student, we have SS2 student, we have SS3. You see that You see the way they're arranging themselves? People always arrange themselves. Okay. Now we come down again. Let's go to table body. That is for table head. Let's now go to table body, which is T-body. T-body. On that table body, we'll now put the name of the students. Okay. So TR, table row. Table row. Let's say the first student is SS3 student. 36 student in SS3. That's right. 36 student STDNT in SS1. Count the number of students. There's 36. Now go to just like that. Copy it and paste it so can make it easy. Just three. Three is okay. So, this is with SS2. SS2 student is 46. See student in SES2. Mm-hmm. And lastly, SES3. Let's say they are 56. Or let's say they are 50, because you know SES3 maybe some people unable to graduate, some people unable to get there. So let's assume that SES3 should be 50 students. Okay. That there are 50 students. Okay. I'm sorry for this. That's a mistake. You should go back to what we are doing. Mm-hmm. 50 students. Okay. So you save your work. And you see it. See the student, list of students, SS1 student, SS2 student, 46, and the auto 50 student. List of senior students, SS1, then SS2 student, SS3 student. And their numbers. Numbers is also showing on the table. So you can also have table description. So it will help you to sorry, there's some mistake that I just created. We are writing TR supposed to in a very wrong place. TR under the table, which is table head, the word supposed to write is TH, not TR. Sorry for that mistake. Look at what I wrote now. TH. That is table head. Okay. Then why under T body, I have table data. Okay. If you do it that way, everything will work out very fine. Then for this, the caption. This caption, so we like to make it, maybe you want to make sure that it's a very good topic, maybe take you to heading one or heading two. Let's say it's heading two. Okay, so turn it to heading two. You know, as usual, those way you put, when you are talking about both, that you can actually put both items on the same page. Can actually make this heading two. How do you do that? Just come over here, press your mouse, H2, it's your heading two number. Bring it down again. Close it, okay, and to come up, then you cut the heading two, so I wrap it over what you want, just the way you've been doing before now, okay. Cut it, take it to where you want it to be, heading two, bring it down here, okay. Control V. So that way, you save, decision, you see it, so it become a list of senior students, supposed to be list. Where do I put the list? Option H2 list of or total number of anything, you know, you can give it your own name, but I prefer this list of senior students. Okay, list of senior students. Then you now do it to SS1, SS2, SS3, and then SS1, you have 56 students in SS1, you have 46 students in SS2, you have 50 students in SS3. You know? So you write it down that way, so it becomes 50 students in SES3. So your write-up should be fine. There are some mistakes that need to correct. If you make any mistake as well, so everything will move on smoothly, okay? Hope you are getting what you are saying, you are getting the whole package. That is the idea. So this is list. And you find out that there's something I want to teach you. Let me expand this. You notice that if you expand it, list to expand, if you bring it, there's a way you shrink it, itself, it will be directing itself, because already, even if it's mobile, even if it's your phone, even if it's your laptop, it will work very well with it. That's what one good thing about table. People give itself direction, increase, reduce, depending on the size and the width of what you are working at. Okay, don't need to worry about that. So, having said that, let's continue with another title I want to show you apart from this.
I like to arrange my work, so let me arrange it the way that everything will be okay. Like this table, let's start with the table type. Then, after the pattern table. My table head here. Let this be the table head. Okay, the head. The head. Yes, then let me take the other part of it and bring it down. And they want to be very, very neat because when your work is neat, you're going to understand what you're doing. And they'll follow it up like that. So, head, let's put there as T head. Yes, now complete it. Then the table body has to also come up. So should I say the table body? And that it doesn't really change anything, but makes our work look very neat. Okay, press, it doesn't change anything, just yeah, work to be neat. Now, I want to test out what we call code span. Code span, for example, if you come to our list of senior students, see that SS1 student is SS1 student, and if there's a student in SS1, see the space, pick up one column space. SS2 student, persistent in SS2, you see, took up one column space. See, you have this space in between. This space. That's what is called code span. Code span will make it that maybe what will handle this SS1 student. Took over like two space, and then before the student, I go to the next space. Okay, that is cool. So I can make it two space, three space, down, and all that. Let me just show you so you understand what I'm trying to do. So let's do under this GD36, which is SS1. Let's use cool span. So it's just a little bit. You press press cool span. Cool span. Yeah, that is the cool span. So let's make the code span to be 2. Let's make it 2. As usual. You see it? So what happened now? Merely we type on code span, you see the space. And SS2, see the space. Took over here, it's with another column, but this then in SS1 took over the 2 space. So that is code span. Let's make it 3 so you get it, understand it better. Let's make it 3. And address, see it, to cover the whole space. So all these things, there may be sometimes that you need it. Maybe you need the space for those particular ones. Like use code span to add that space up. Okay. Are you getting all your discussing? Are you getting the gist? Are you getting the coding? Feel free to ask questions. If you have any question, feel free to ask. And don't always forget to subscribe to my channel. Bring your contribution. By way of bringing an input, maybe asking a question or telling us what you think the best way to do it, because there's no one way to coding. I'm open to discussion. Okay, thank you so much for listening to me. Let's continue. So with CodeSpy, you can actually direct how many columns each row should have. You know, table, like we said, has a lot of but for me it's not that difficult, as long as you can see them well indented and you know the right part to use. But it'll work out fine. Okay. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like, subscribe, bring contribution. But what I mean, because I'm talking about you bringing me money, no contribution, I can contribute. Tell me, I will not be this, you bring suggestion and all that. Okay, thank you so much. Let's go back. See you in the next.